SQL, which is Structured Query Language, is a language used for managing relational databases. A database is the collection of data, and a relational database is a database in which data items get stored in tables with some relation between those data items and tables. MySQL, PostgreSQL, MariaDB, and SQLite are some examples of relational databases. You can install any of these to get started with relational databases and SQL. I'll be using MariaDB throughout this video. You can follow the link in the comments for a step-by-step installation of MariaDB in Linux or Windows. With the help of SQL, we can create, update, delete, and do other operations to control data items in the database. To create a database, you can use create database command and then your database name, like school and the semicolon. To use the database that we have just created, type use and then the database name and semicolon. As I told you earlier, a relational database is a collection of tables. So let's create some tables in our database. This is the syntax for creating tables in SQL. First, we have to type create table and then if not exist. This is optional. It only means create the table if no other table with the same name is found in the database. After that, the table name, for example books, and then in brackets, the column names, like name, in which we will store the name of the books and then the data type of that column. Since it is the name, the data type can be varchar, which means text with a variable length. We can specify the max size in brackets, for example 20. Then the optional parameters like not null, which means that this column should not be empty. We can have infinite columns separated by commas in our table. Let's add one more column, price, and the data type will be int. That is integer. Type the semicolon and hit enter. This will create a table named books in your database, in which you can only store book names and prices. Now that we have created our first table, let's enter some data into this table. This is the syntax for inserting data into the tables. First, we need to type insert into, then table name, then the table's columns in brackets, and then the values in the same order as the column names, and at the last, semicolon. You can skip the part of entering column names while adding data to the tables if you are entering data in all columns of the table. A book has only two columns. So if I want to enter data in both of those columns, I can type insert into book values and then the values in brackets. But make sure you keep the values in the same order as your columns in your table. Now that we have entered data into our table, how can we view it? You can use select query to fetch data from the tables. So, to view the data of our books table, we can type select and then star, which means display all columns, and then type from, then the table name, that is books and the semicolon. This is our first table. Suppose you want to display only some columns instead of all columns of the table. For that, you can replace star with the column name separated by the commas. This will only show the columns that you have specified. Like here, I just enter the column name, and only the name column of the books table is displayed. While fetching data using the select query, you can use the where clause to specify the conditions, like select star from books where price is equal to 200. This will only show the books which cost 200. You can also combine additional conditions using and or operators. Like in this table, we got employees, first name and last names, job titles, etc. So, if I want to fetch data of some employee using the first name and job title, my SQL query will be like this. Select star from employee where EMPF name equals Tony and job equals software engineer, where this EMPF name and job are the columns of the table. Here, I used AND operator. So, select query will only fetch the data when both values are true. In this case, the values matched only for a single employee. But if I change AND with OR, the select query will fetch all the rows where the name is Tony or the job is a software engineer. So while using OR, if any of the condition is true, the select query will fetch the data. Tell me in the comment section which logical operators are used when comparing usernames and passwords on website, AND or OR logical operator. We can delete rows from table using the delete query in SQL. If I want to delete the data of Tony Stark from this table named employee, because Tony Stark is not an employee, he is our hero, I can type delete from the table name, that is employee, and then where conditions like empfname equals Tony and emplname equals Stark. This will delete the record of Tony Stark from this employee table. To update some data in the table, use the update query. Like in this books table, if I want to update the price of any book, I can use this query. Update books, set price equals 100, where name equals hacking basics. In this query, books is the table name. The set is used to set a new value to the column. Here, price is the column name of the table books and then the where condition to specify the row to update. And now, the price is 100. You can also order the data fetched from the database in ascending or descending order. Using order by clause and column name, then ASC for ascending and DESC for descending order. This will order the rows in ascending or descending order with the help of the given column data items. Like here, all the rows are ordered in ascending order according to their first names. You can also do all arithmetic operations in SQL like this. Select 2 plus 2, this will add it. Select 2 minus 2 for subtraction. Select 2 star 3 for multiplication. You get the idea. We can combine our SQL queries with these arithmetic operations. Suppose I want to update the price of all books by 10%. My SQL query will look like this. Update books, set price equals price into 1.1. This query will multiply the current price value with 1.1, increasing it by 10% and then update it. If we want to count the number of items we have in the table, like here, we can count that there are 2 books in this table. But if the table is big, we can use a count function like this. Select count and in brackets column name, that is name, from books, where the name is the column and books is our table. And this will count all the data items in that column. Here it is simply 2. Like count, we can use min to get the minimum value in that column. Like here, it should be 110. Like min, we can get the maximum value too using max function. And to get the sum of all values of a column, we can use sum. And for the average value, we can use AVG. We can modify the columns of created tables too. In this books table, I've got only 2 columns, name and price. If I want to add one more column like author, I can do that using alter function. To add an author column in the books table, the SQL query will be this. Alter table, books, add column, author, varchar 20. Alter table to modify the table, books is the table name. Add column is the keyword for adding columns. Author is the new column I want to add and varchar 20 is the character data type with max 20 characters. Now, we got an author column in our books table. The values are null because we have not added any value. We can update those values using update SQL queries. If I want to add a column after some specific column, like after name column, I want to add book ID column, then my SQL query will be like this. Alter table books add ID int after name, where ID is the name of the new column and int is the data type. I want ID column after the name column, so after name and semicolon. To rename a table name, we can use rename command. Like to rename this books table to novels, I need to type rename table books to novels, where books is the old table name and novels is the new table name that I want. To change the column names, you can use change keyword. Like to change the name of the price column to rate, my SQL query will be this. Alter table novels change column price rate varchar 20, where novels is the table name, price is the old column name and rate is the new column name with varchar data type. Now let's drop our tables and columns. In SQL, dropping means deleting. To delete this ID column from this novels table, my SQL query will be this. Alter table novels drop column ID, where alter table is the function to modify tables and then novels is our table name, then drop column keyword to delete the column and then ID is the column name that we want to delete. Now we no longer see the ID column in our novels table. Why stop here? Let's delete the whole table. It is so simple. Just type drop table and then the table name that is novels and semicolon. But why drop a single table when we can drop this whole database? To delete a database, type drop database and then database name. Why stop here? Let's drop this entire operating system. Anyway, that's it. Remember to drop a like.